Where are we going?
Morty Alec.
Good morning.
So these holidays, me, Dylan and Heath decided to hike slash hitchhike the Mornington Peninsula. We went from Mornington to Point Nepean. It was 50k and we either walked or got a ride. And this is our trip.
We have started the trek at Mornington.
We're already having an argument.
Because he threw away my drink bottle.
Where are we?
Mount Martha.
You missed it. We made it to Mount Martha now. We're going to take a break. And when we get to dromana, we're going to have lunch.
Gonna take a break here.
Oh,
it's so shit. Don't go down
there. The whole time walking from Mount Martha to dromana, we had our thumbs up, hoping someone would pull over to give us a lift. And luckily, this guy in a truck named James gave us a lift, which saved us 2 hours of walking.
Our goal was to hitchhike somewhere.
Thank you, mate. Have a good one.
We're along Mount Martha and we've got our thumbs up for ages. And then this truck stops in the middle of the winding road. Double lines, we had to just jump in. I didn't get to film anything.
We then got lunch in dromana, but also got attacked by seagulls.
It started raining, so whipped out the poncho, I think.
This is Dylan's water source and he's lost the cat.
This is insane. It rained on.
After basically getting caught in a sandstorm, we made it to Rosebud.
Okay, let me get. Are you from the pack?
There we go.
Now made it to Tootgarook.
So we had finally made it to Rye, which is our destination for the night. Night breezes seem to whisper. So at the beginning of the day, we started the hike here in Mornington. Then we got to Mount Martha, then dromana, this is Arthur's Seat. Then through Rosebud and mcrae to Rye. We were really tired, we got Subway for dinner. Then we caught an Uber to the back beach, which we justified as not cheating, since we were still walking the peninsula, we were just going backwards to sleep.
It is probably 8 hours later and Dylan has found the cap for his water bottle that he had to throw out. And also we're building the tent now. I'm alone and blue as can be. Alright, the tent has been set up and now we're gonna make some hot chocolate on the Trangia. Stars fading, but I linger on the
This s'more is solid.
We then headed to bed, but we started having problems with the tent.
Let's chuck the ponchos on, baby.
The fly.
No, I really don't need to
know. The fly just fell off and it won't stay on.
So the rain cover just kept flying off in the wind.
We should just take it all off then.
No, if it rains, we're gonna be
fucked. How do we put it on the inside?
We can't.
Decided to just not put it back on. We are now using the rain cover as a big blanket for everyone in case it rains. It's getting grim.
It's getting pretty bad. It's getting worse and worse by the night.
So the second day was also the last day of our trip. We were heading from Rye Back Beach to Rye Front Beach so we could then continue along the peninsula to Point Nepean. On the way we met this really cool horse.
He touched the electric wire.
I had a go, mate.
Dylan touched the electric fence and got shocked. We tried to get a hitchhike to the front beach. We got this really nice lady who pulled over, but she just told us that she had a bike in the back and couldn't take us. So sad. And then this other nice guy pulled over and he gave us a lift to Blair Gowrie, which was even better. Rose got in and he has this little dog called Gizmo and he just started attacking Dylan. It was really cute, the dog.
Blair Gowrie Shopping Centre.
At Blair Gowrie, we got lunch at this place called Beach Box. I highly recommend. Then we began our walk from Blair Gowrie to Sorrento. It was actually probably my favourite walk of the hike. It was just really nice and scenic.
We made it.
We luckily made it to Sorrento just in time before it started pouring down. When we got there, we took a while. We had a break. We got some hot chocolate / coffees. And then we waited for the rain to clear up a little bit before we started our trek from Sorrento to Portsea, which was a 45-minute walk, but a 5-minute drive. Luckily, this really nice lady pulled over and gave us a lift. Then from Portsea, we started our walk to Point Nepean. Luckily again, a really nice guy, an electrician man, pulled over and gave us a lift. So Point Nepean is a national park and the road only goes halfway, and from that halfway point you can't drive, so we had to walk to the end. So this guy gave us a lift as far as he could and then we just started walking the way. Being rained on.
Alright, in case you don't know, in Australia we had a Prime Minister called Harold Holt. He went swimming out here and then he just never returned.
We made it to the very tip. And then after that, all we did was go explore all like the old war ruins. And then we walked about an hour and a half back to Portsea, got a bus back to dromana where we had dinner, then mum picked us up and went home.
We're gonna explore these abandoned bus.
Also, we got jumped at by a rat.
It's here, it's on the wall.
And this was our trip to the morning.
Quickly, guys.
Keep it.